This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I want to demonstrate how to do synthetic division with imaginary numbers. So let's say you're given a problem like this. You're given this polynomial, 3x to the fourth plus 4x to the third minus 3x squared plus 16x minus 60. And you're told to factor it completely. And the only other information you're given is that the imaginary number 2i is a zero of this number, of this polynomial. Okay? So we can solve this whole thing with synthetic division. As with normal synthetic division, we're going to copy down all of the coefficients of this polynomial. When we do this, we want to leave plenty of room in between the coefficients. As we do this, you'll see why all that room is necessary. So I had 3, 4, negative 3, 16, and negative 60. Put a half box around that. And then we're told that 2i is a zero of this function. Whatever zero we're given, we just use that as the divisor. Just as it is, we don't change its sign. Okay, now we proceed. And we're going to follow the same rules we used for regular synthetic division. We bring down the first number, the 3, and we multiply that number that we brought down, the 3, and the divisor, 2i. So we get 6i. We write that in the next column. And then we add the numbers in the next column together. We've got 4 plus 6i, so I have to write that as just 4 plus 6i. And then I multiply. I've got 2i times 4 plus 6i. Well, 2i times 4 is 8i. I'll write that underneath the negative 3 in the next column. And I've also got 2i times 6i. Well, 2 times the 6 is 12. I times I is I squared. Remember that I squared is negative 1. So if we've got 12i squared, that's actually negative 12. So the total product that I get is negative 12 plus 8i. Now I want to add that along with the other number in that column, the negative 3. Add those together. I get a negative 15 plus 8i. And I multiply again. I've got a 2i and a negative 15. So that's going to be negative 30i. And I've got 2i and 8i. I multiply those together, that'd be 16i squared, which is negative 16. So I've got a negative 16 minus 30i. And I'm adding that together with the 16. Well, the 16 and negative 16 cancel, and I end up with just negative 30i. And then when I multiply my last time, I get 2i times negative 30i, that'd be negative 60i squared, which is positive 60. Write that in my last column, add the two numbers in the last column together, and I get a zero, which is good, because if 2i is a zero of this original polynomial, then I would have to have a zero remainder. Okay, now, I'm going to take what I've got here, this series of complex numbers, and divide that again. Remember, when you're dealing with imaginary numbers as zeros of a function, they come in pairs, in positive and negative pairs. So if 2i was one of the zeros, then negative 2i also has to be a zero. So I'm going to take the answer I just got and divide that by negative 2i. I'll begin the process again. Bring down the 3. Multiply 3 times negative 2i. That's going to be negative 6i. I'm adding that to 4 plus 6i. The imaginary parts, the 6i and the negative 6i, will cancel, and I end up with just a 4. I multiply negative 2i times 4 is negative 8i. I add that to negative 15 plus 8i, and I get just a negative 15. You see that all those imaginary parts are canceling out as we go along. Okay, the last multiplication is negative 2i minus 15 is positive 30i. Add that to the last column. Those two are going to cancel, negative 30i and positive 30i. So once again, I get a zero remainder, which is good, because I knew that negative 2i had to also be a zero of this function. And now I'm left with 3, 4, and negative 15. Well, I did two rounds of synthetic division. Each time I do a round of synthetic division, I reduce the exponent powers by 1. So instead of having x to the fourth, I went down to x to the third, and this will now be x to the x squared. So what I've got here is x squared plus 4x minus 15. And if you were told to factor this original polynomial completely, or find all of the zeros of it, the last step, which I'm going to let you do, would be to take this trinomial, 3x squared plus 4x minus 15, just a straightforward quadrilateral, and factor that down into two binomials. Okay? And that's about all there is to it. Synthetic division with imaginary numbers is really following exactly the same rules that you use for regular synthetic division. You just have to remember the rules for imaginary numbers, that I times I is I squared, and I squared equals negative 1. Okay, that's it. Take care, and I'll see you next time.